whole show. We've got nowhere to go. Here we are, we can't go far. It's the Rotten Apple Show.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to episode 5 of the Rotten Apple Show. My name's Kelsey.
And my name is Shine.
And we are Rotten Apple.
That's right. Thank you, folks. As you can see, if you've been here before, we've found some equipment that we haven't been able to use.
Woo!
Thank you, quarantine, for giving us the time to learn it. Let us know if you like this setup better or if you like our
Homemade backdrop.
Homemade backdrop. We'd love to hear your comments, but we're just having fun here. This is all DIY. You know, you guys know us from producing comedy shows over the last 2 years out in the beautiful Chelan Valley, whether you're in Chelan, Manson, Wenatchee. Thank you so much if you're joining us tonight. We love you so much, all our friends and family and new viewers. If you're new to the show, thank you and welcome. We appreciate you so much. And like I mentioned, we've been putting on shows for the last 2 years, and we can't do that anymore right now. So we've decided to take our show and stream it live from our home
to yours.
And we've been having a blast. What this show is about is that Kelsey and I get a little silly. We have some skits. We actually have a brand new segment today from our partner, Jesse. And of course, we get to catch up with some of our favorite people that we've come across over the last 2 years, some comedians that these guys, they've been on HBO, Netflix, Comedy Central, and it's so fun to catch up with them again.
It is, and tonight we've got the Hawaiian Kermet Apio! He was with us in Chelan and Wenatchee last year, and he was absolutely a crowd favorite. You might have seen him on his Dry Bar special, SiriusXM. He's fantastic, and we just love him. He's a really, really nice guy. Yeah. And he actually gave us some really great tips while he was in town, too, and we really appreciate that. So we're going to go live with him in just a little bit.
Now, speaking of tips.
Oh, nice.
Like
nice.
That. See, see, see. Now, folks, just by watching the show, of course, we appreciate it and you're supporting us. And if you are able to, we have two ways of supporting us. One is through Venmo right over here. And those tips we'll be splitting with Kermet tonight. So if you're having a good time during the show, feel free to send us some tips on Venmo. Otherwise, for ongoing support, we have a Patreon set up over here, and that allows you to become a part of the Rotten Apple crew, a Rotten to the Core member. If you donate for 3 months, you can get this cool t-shirt, plus get your names on the credits. So we're having a good time here, so we just want to thank you for supporting and watching the show. It means a lot to us. We love you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. And what... So we have lots of fun things to cover tonight. First one being what we like to call the meme stream. And this allows us to all just kind of sit back, loosen up, get into the groove, and remember why we're here, which is to laugh and you know, make the best of a situation. So without further ado, let's get into the meme stream. All right, so first up, okay, when your hair salon is closed, but your dog groomer has a cancellation.
Now, this one is personal to me because I just found my barber in Chelan.
He did.
About 4 or 5 weeks ago. Awesome guy. Shout out to Nate, Sacramento. Hey, but you know what? We got to take Cole in sometime, and I might just take him on the offer, do a little beard trim. I like this guy's haircut, by the way.
I actually kind of like it. It's like a fashion mullet.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, let's move on.
What else we got?
Oh,
snap! Shout out to Rotten Apple. Us, we created our first meme.
Our first meme.
Threw it in there. Slipped it in.
Give them some backstory on this. I asked my mom for TP, and this is what I got. What does this mean over here?
So, funny thing is, if you know my mom, Stacy Guy, she is a very crafty lady, and she likes to do a lot of things with different kind of sticks and wood and ponds and all sorts of outdoor stuff. This one in particular is from her birch trees. She decided to literally make a teepee, and we were actually having a social distancing Easter, and I have a niece who's about 1.5, and to, you know, keep her distance, we said, let's make a special spot for Zena so we can make sure we stay away from hers. This is her special little teepee spot, and we just took this opportunity to create a meme. So there it is.
Thank you. All right, next up. When you're trying to talk in her ear and she's ticklish.
Okay. So this is totally me because I'm extremely ticklish, and we all know about that ugly face we make when you're laughing. So this is just kind of shining light on, you know, princesses are humans too, and they also make ugly faces. I love that one so much.
All right, next up. Now, I don't even know where this one's from, but this noodle head guy cracks me up. I mean, you got to love his ingenuity. And this one, God bless whoever found this photo. Awesome.
Well, and honestly, that place does look really crowded, so I don't blame the guy. Because honestly, if it wasn't, look at that. Look at all the people surrounding him. If it wasn't for those noodles, I think he's doing a really good job of keeping that distance.
So. All right, let's move on.
Okay.
This is my impression of dogs see each other across the street. All right, so Cole. I see. That's Cole's face. That's our dog's face. Ooh. And then it gets a little crazy.
Then he's like, I don't think I want to fight you. That's great. Oh, my God. All right. Well, that's cute.
Next up.
Most of my favorite. Okay, so this is an impression of Usher and what he does in quarantine. And he's really got those moves down.
He's got it on repeat. Look at that.
Oh, that's my favorite. Wait. And then it just keeps going back and back. And Usher. I'm actually getting a little bit sad for Usher right now, thinking about this.
Shout out to Usher. If you haven't seen the Rotten Apple Usher parody, go check it out. Yeah. Facebook.
We love Usher.
All right, we get it. We get the point here, I think. Usher, keep doing your thing.
And that was Mainstream. Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed that. I hope we're all loose. We got our drinks. We're getting ready to party and laugh and have a good time. We got a few more segments here before we get into the main event.
So next up, like we mentioned earlier, our partner Jesse's been making some videos, and we want to share a funny one with you guys. Let's jump right into it. Yeah.
I'm having an identity crisis, I think. So my whole life, I have been a Thin Mint person. What kind of Girl Scout cookies do you want this year, Uncle Jesse? Thin Mints, duh. Thin Mints, right? But last year, for the first time, I gave the samosa a shot. And this year, I'm officially no longer a Thin Mint man. I have 2 full boxes of Thin Mints, and I have 4 samosas left. I'm not sure what Thin Mint did to offend me. I think it's just the power of the samosas are so good. I'm like full-blown divorced from Thin Mint. I'm out the door. If I had kids with Thin Mint, I would even like be like, whatever. Samosa, I love you. Minutes up. If you have more some boxes of samosa, please let me know. I need another box.
Okay, quick side note. Quick side note from Jesse himself. He knows the difference between a Samoa and a samosa. So his bad on the video. Just to let everybody know.
And just, in case you were just, thinking that. Just so you're clear, she's a Thin Mint and I'm a samosa, if that makes it very clear, right?
I might be veering more towards samosa though later on. But
All right. Okay. All right, folks. Next up, we got one of our fan favorite segments. Now, this is our roommate / my father-in-law.
And my daddy.
You know what? His name is Kevin, and he's got a wonderful take on the world. So we continue to ask him questions. And folks, once you get a little bit of what his personality is like, you might recognize somebody just like Kevin. So without further ado, here's our favorite person in the world, Kevin in
Kevin's Corner. What's a weekend? Jeez. I get up on a Saturday. She's got a honey-do list already made out. Start speed reading that, getting ready to go. Oh, it's just never ending. I've got sprinklers to turn on. I got faucets to fix. I got shelves to build, barbecue tanks to fill. I don't know, I don't even have time to shine my own shoes. Sometimes I don't even know why I get up. Don't get me started on weekends. Fashion. Well, I'm a firm believer in trendy as the last stage before tacky. I take a lot of thought and discipline in what I wear. I put on a pretty good t-shirt every day. I've got jeans that'll rock anybody's world. And my socks. I've got socks older than my kids, but they're still in style. And it's nothing like a good hoodie, you know what I mean? Make sure that string is always east side. What can I say? The end of the day, fashion saved my life. And that's Kevin's Corner.
Kevin, yes. Dad, we share the same love of fashion. So yeah. Thank you for letting us in on that part of your heart.
Yeah, he's a perfect combination of form and function when it comes to clothing. Wouldn't you say so?
Absolutely.
All right.
So we're almost ready for our main event. Before we get into that, we like to share our specials. So sit back and relax.
And just a reminder, we'll be putting up the Venmo link at the top. So any tips that you can send, we'll be splitting with Kermit Apio. Without further ado,
let's look at this clip.
You never see Hawaiians where they're supposed to be. You ever watch that Pearl Harbor movie? Apparently there were no Hawaiians in Hawaii. Looks like the Japanese attacked Idaho for some reason. What happened? I was in Charlotte, North Carolina. Get this, 20 Hawaiians came to see the show in Charlotte, North Carolina. 20. I was thinking, well, this must be witness protection program. 20 people made that decision. I am sick of paradise. Honey, North Carolina. Pack it up. I'm tired of 80% humidity. Let's go for 97. Let's do this. If I see another rainbow, I'm going to freak. 20, there are more Hawaiians in Charlotte, North Carolina than there were on 9 years of Magnum PI. Once again, for those of you under 40, it was a show in Hawaii with no Hawaiians. Have you seen that new Hawaii 5-0? There's a couple Hawaiians on there. Okay. But here's a secret. They're Korean. Only missed it by an ocean. You never see Hawaiians where they're supposed to be. You ever watch that Pearl Harbor movie? Apparently there were no Hawaiians in Hawaii during World War II. Looks like the Japanese attacked Idaho for some reason. What happened? You couldn't find one Hawaiian actor who could do this? You know where you do see Hawaiians on TV? Dog the Bounty Hunter. There's my peeps right there. How high do you have to be to get caught by Dog the Bounty Hunter? Really? Wow, there's 3 SUVs, a camera crew, and a mullet the size of a Clydesdale. Dude, I'm going to wait here and see how this plays out. That's an impressive mullet. If you're going to go mullet, go all the way. That is a black belt mullet. That is business in the front and Christina Aguilera in the back. It's like a jellyfish wearing a Trojan helmet. It's gorgeous. And what better way to accessorize a mullet? Yes, leather, absolutely. Leather pants, leather tank top, I believe that is.
Okay. Hi, folks.
Hey, guys. We're getting on the phone with Kermet. We're having a little bit of a technical difficulty.
Yes.
Welcome to live stream. This... Am I right? The showbiz, baby.
Yes.
Okay.
Kelsey's going to dance for you while we get Kermet on the phone, okay? To the Skype song. Come on.
Bum,
bum, Kermet! Oh, my God. We did it.
What's up, Kermet? We thought we lost you forever.
As soon as I started playing the clips, everything just kind of went out, and I just thought, did I make it somehow?
No,
you're fine. You're fine. Thank you, folks at home. We appreciate your patience. We worked through some internet and computer stuff, but now we're here with Kermet. Kermet Apio, everybody.
Studio audience sounds great.
Oh yeah, yeah. It's all about the studio audience, though. It's recorded in a studio.
How are you, Kermet?
I'm doing well. I'm doing well. Spending more time with the family than I think they might want. I'm usually gone about half the time, so it's been kind of fun to be with them, and I'm sure annoying for them.
Quite the adjustment, I bet, right?
Yeah. speaking of family, you know, when you were here back in Chelan, we had such a good time. Mm-hmm. As soon as we finished the first show in Wenatchee, we had a chance to go to Applebee's.
Oh, yeah.
It was me, you, Robert Pitty, and like all four of us were just so hungry. We had a family meal together, and that was so fun. And I just remember you being so nice, and after the show, just like being such an awesome guy. We just want to thank you for that and appreciate that.
I appreciate that. Feeling is definitely mutual. That was the first time Robert and I met the two of you. Mm-hmm. And as we were driving to Chelan after that fun dinner, we had that kind of comedian thing, like, are they as nice as they seem? Like, what's the angle here?
Yeah, sometimes people get worried.
They're like, what happens when we go to Chelan?
Yeah, from that drive from Wenatchee to Chelan, people get worried. So for people that live in LA or other places, last year we had a show in two cities 40 miles apart. So our comedians were a little worried that we were going to kill them.
Yeah. But we didn't, and the proof is that you're here with us now. So
yeah,
we're excited to have you. We have some fun things lined up. We got some questions for you. We're going to be opening it up to the audience as well.
That's
so
right.
Audience, if you have questions for Kermet, ask us some fun, silly questions, and we'll get those going.
Speaking of silly questions, Kermet, we just want to ask you the hard-hitting questions. That's what Rotten Apple does. So our first question is, what would you do if you found a penguin in your freezer? That's what the people want to know.
That's wow. You just cut right.
Yeah, he did.
You just get personal. boy. If it's alive, I give it a name because that's a dream come true. If it's not alive, then we got a whole another ball game there. I got to figure out what the kids are eating nowadays, you know. But I'm hoping it's alive because I've always wanted a penguin.
Your next question.
Yeah, you can always turn into an otter pop. All right, next up.
But it's a penguin.
Kermet, how would you sell hot cocoa in Florida?
How would I sell hot cocoa? Just tell them it's iced tea. You know what I mean? Like just go full salesman route. It's a hip iced tea. French.
It's French.
The ice is so.
That's great.
No, I gotta ask this just because you've talked about this before, but you know, with a name like Kermet, can you just tell us just like some of the most the memories that stand out the most about growing up? Because my name is Shaimoom, and I got everything from Shamu to shampoo to shroom. Some of these I can't even say on the air. So tell me about your experience growing up with this name Kermet, because I'm sure you got some stories.
Well, there is not a specific story. It's just one of those things that it was constant, right? I mean, and I know kids get teased for everything when they're growing up. So for me, but it was just this constant, like that first day of school, you just know that any kid who doesn't know you you're just waiting for that laugh to come when they take an attendance, you know, and then that teacher says Kermit Apio, and you just hear it. You just hear the Snickers, and you just go, okay, here it comes, another 8 months of this. And and then, but I grew up in a semi-rough neighborhood, so that's kind of why I'm doing what I do today, because I realized I was much better at laughing about it and continuing the jokes they were making than I was at fighting. Learned that quickly.
Nice. Well, way to take the bull by the horns and use it to your advantage.
Yeah.
My last name, well, it's not Guy. Oh. What was that?
I said I noticed that if I tease myself first, it wasn't fun for them. It wasn't as fun since I did it already, you know?
Right. Smart.
And, took the power away.
Yeah. And here I am telling jokes for bars for years.
Here we are. All right. What else we got?
I've caught a little bit of what you've been doing online, and you've been doing some fun stuff. And that's what's really cool about checking with comedians is that you, at the end of the day, you guys are artists, and you've really found ways to continue to to connect with people. And why don't you talk about what you've been doing to connect with people as a comedian?
Yeah.
Well, one of the things I've been doing is on Facebook. I've been with my kids. I've been doing a segment we call it's called Social Distance Sequestered Family Time Killers, and we just do kind of suggestions to people to kill time while at home. And then the other thing I've been doing is really fun is I also play Hawaiian music a lot. And so on Wednesday evenings at 6 o'clock Pacific time, I've been doing an hour of Hawaiian music. And I just did it as kind of a silly thing the first week, and people kept asking me to keep doing it. And so I've really enjoyed that. So every Wednesday at 6, I just play I play Hawaiian music for an hour. And sometimes my daughter joins me on ukulele, and we have a lot of fun.
That's so cool.
So Wednesday at 6 p.m., that's 3 p.m. Hawaiian time. Is that right?
Well, actually, it's 4 p.m. Hawaiian time because we're always late.
Would you be open to playing a little something for us?
Yes. So I would love to do a song. Now, this isn't a Hawaiian song, and you'll be able to tell that because you'll understand the words.
Okay.
You'll see.
Okay.
It's not a Hawaiian song. It's a song I wrote that is sort of very appropriate to kind of this this time we're in right now. And it's a song about what you wish for. And sometimes can regret, but it's about what you kind of wish would happen. The song is called I Wish, and I'd like to dedicate it to your wonderful viewers who are joining us. And I love that you're swaying already, and I haven't even started. That's awesome.
we're really feeling the vibe. Okay. As soon as you put that harmonica on, I just...
Hawaiians are late. We're just really early.
All right, so this song is called I Wish.
All right.
Wish I could see in the darkness. Wish I could breathe in the light. Wish I could stand up to the dragon, and I wish that I could always fight the good fight. Wish I could be standing next to you. Wish I'd know what to say. But most of all, at this very moment, I wish that I could play this harmonica. Woo! Wish I thought this whole thing all the way through. I wish this story was complete. Most of all, at this very moment, I wish I kept the receipt for this harmonica. For this harmonica. For this harmonica. For this harmonica. Solo. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Wow. Oh my gosh. What an emotional song. Hey, Janice says, aloha. Great song. Keep this going. Love it. So kudos to you, Kermit. Keep it going.
Thank you very much. And tell Janet thank you.
Yes. Folks, we got Kermit Apio here once again. A multi-talented comedian. Any tips that you send over to Venmo at Rotten Apple Crew will be splitting with Kermit. Mm-hmm. You know, this is such an awesome thing that you're doing, Kermit. You know, to show your side, not only your musical side, but then to get your daughter involved and make it a family affair. I mean, that's really what it's about. You know, for me and Kelsey, I don't know. Did you get a chance to see Kevin's Corner? Like this is kind of like our way of connecting during this time and having fun with it. Like, tell us what it means to you to like be have a chance to spend time with your family in ways that you haven't done for a long time as a traveling comedian.
That has been so much fun, and we're having a blast. Usually when I sort of tell them we're going to shoot an episode, they're just kind of typical teenager kids, you know, like but once we get started, we have so much fun. Like one of the episodes, the episode was called Laundry Juggling, because we had a bunch of clean laundry on the couch that needed to be folded. And so we did a laundry juggling segment of the show. And it was just the three of us literally throwing clothes up in the air and having fun. And so, yeah, it's been a blast. And you know, you just try and make the most out of it. And like I said earlier, as a traveling comic, to spend this kind of time with my kids is, it's been kind of wonderful, you know, difficult, like everybody is dealing with, but man, we've had so much fun. And so between the music and doing these time killer segments, we're having a blast.
Oh, that's good to hear. Do you want to play a game with us?
Yeah.
I would love to. Absolutely.
Do you want to play a game? That
was very sinister sounding.
Hey, Kermit, do you want to play a game?
Okay. Okay, so this is the game. It's kind of... it's kind of in the same realm of what we've been doing. We're going to be asking you questions, but this time we're going to ask them... and we want you to give us the quickest answer you can come up with, okay? So we're going to do it for about a minute, okay? And just don't think. Just give us the answers. There actually is a right answer, but we're just going to see what your brain does when we put you on the spot, okay? Okay, should we set a timer?
Yes.
Okay, sure. We're going to set a timer.
Before we start, is there a comedian curve? Like, am I going to be compared to other comedians that have done this?
You're actually the curve, because you're the first person we're doing this with. So,
I'm the standard by which everyone else has to do this from now on.
Yes, you are the model. So everyone else has to do as good as you. So do good. Okay.
Oh, all right. No pressure.
No pressure.
First she comes at you like Jigsaw, and then she says, do good. Oh my gosh.
Okay, am I asking the questions? Okay, yes. So we're going to put 60 seconds on the clock, and we're just going to see what you come up with, okay? All right, on your mark, get set,
okay.
Go. What two things can you never eat for breakfast?
Steak and shoes.
What gets wetter the more it dries?
Ice.
Wait, we should say the answers, right?
It's a towel.
A towel, all right.
What word is spelled incorrectly in every single dictionary?
Woodpecker.
It's incorrectly.
The word incorrectly.
What never asks a question but gets answered all the time?
Uber drivers.
Close, but it's your cell phone.
No, you know what? Screw that, Kermit. Uber drivers. That's the right answer. That one's right.
What goes up but never comes down?
Debt.
Oh, ooh, that's a good one. It's your age, but debt works too. Okay, we got time for two more. A girl fell off a 50-foot ladder but didn't get hurt. What? How come?
I don't know. There was a trampoline. I have nothing for this.
She fell off the bottom rung.
Okay.
That's a trick her.
Yeah, that one was mean. That one was mean. I loved your answers, especially the debt, yeah, especially the Uber driver. So your grade for today is A plus.
Woo! Can we get a sound effect for that?
It's just one of those technical days. Kermit, thank you so much once again, folks. You can find Kermit Apio on Facebook and Wednesday nights at 6 p.m. Check him out. He'll be doing music. He'll be with his family. You got a sample of it. Kermit, thank you so much for joining us. This is an honor. You know, we're having so much fun here just doing our show, but it just makes it that much more special. We have people like you, great guys like you to join and just be a part of this crazy time that we're in right now.
Well, I appreciate you having me on. And I told you this before when I worked with you. Not only were your shows a lot of fun, but Robert and I genuinely enjoyed working with the two of you just as people. And so I'm flattered that you have me on, but it really was my thrill. And I wish you guys the best. I hope we can cross paths in person at some point in the future.
We do too. Yeah, we hope we can get back to those live shows sooner than later. We'd love to have you back in Chelan and Wenatchee.
Thanks, Kermit. Take care.
Thanks, Kermit.
Folks.
Take care.
All right, folks. That's Kermit Apio. Thank you so much for watching today, guys. It's been a blast. I know we had a couple of funny things go on technically, but you guys powered through it, and
that's
showbiz. It's live TV. I'm surprised it hasn't happened yet. Let us know about what you think about our new backdrop and the lighting and everything. We're messing around, trying some new things, but we'd appreciate your feedback. So leave it in the comments or just let us know on Facebook or on Instagram, on Twitter. We're everywhere. Find us. We'd love your feedback.
Absolutely. And for all of our locals watching tonight, you know, there's so many different things happening in the community. We love our community. We love the way that we've come together in these hard times. We do have a special sticker for the Chelan Valley Strong group. And if you're looking to contribute in a local way, donating to your local food bank is a really great way to do so. They are currently down 70% in all of their food donations. So any sort of donation to them right now is really great. So if you want to get a cool sticker and support a local food bank while you're at it, hit up the Chelan Valley Strong sticker.
That's right, folks. And once again, tips that you are able to send to Venmo. We split tonight with Kermit Apio. He was awesome. He's musical. And, you know, we're all in this together. And we appreciate your support so much. For ongoing support, please go to our Patreon. Otherwise, what do we have going on next week?
Oh, yeah. Next week. So we are switching for a few weeks. We did Tuesdays and Thursdays. And to give you guys more of an experience, to give ourselves some time to really focus on the production aspect of this show, you know, it looks like we're going to be in this for quite some time. So we're really working on that. And we're going to switch this to just Thursday nights at 7 p.m. And next week on Thursday at 7 p.m., we are going to have Erica Rhodes, who joined us a few years back with Ian Begg and as an opener. And she has since gone on to be a phenomenal headliner, touring all over the country. She's hilarious. She's sarcastic and just so great. I can't wait to hear what she's been up to during quarantine. And I know it's been a lot. So check us out next Thursday at 7 p.m.
Yeah. So until then, thank you so much for watching. We love you.
Good night.
It's the Rotten Apple Show. We've got nowhere to go. Here we are. We can't go far. It's the Rotten Apple Show.